Your half yearly is coming. So, start to do hard work for your half yearly examinations. Hope you will start and you will not disappoint your teachers and your parents also. We have done chapter number 1 earlier, but now I am starting chapter numbers 1, some topics. Today I will start from computer languages. We will start. Computer applications, class 6, computer language. Today I will explain computer language. First, we know what is computer. As you know, a computer is an electronic device that operates according to the instructions stored in its memory. Instructions which we will give to the computer, that is known as the instructions. On that instruction, computer can start to do their work. Computers are used in various fields in our daily life. You know, in our daily life, we need computer everywhere. Without computer, we cannot live our life easily. So, nowadays, computer plays an important role in our life. Computers have taken industries and business to a whole new level. Now, computer language. As you know that when we are communicate with any people, with any other country's people, first we know the language of that country. If we don't know the language, then we cannot communicate with them. For this, we know about the computer language to communicate with the computer system. So, a language is the main medium of communicating between the computer system, and the most common are the programming languages. As we know, a computer only understands binary numbers. That binary numbers is 0 and 1. That 0 and 1 to perform various operations, but the languages are developed for different types of work on a computer, because computer cannot understand the English language or any other language. It is understanding only binary numbers. By this binary numbers, the new language developed. So we say that a language consists of all the instructions to make a request to the system for processing a task. From the first generation and now fourth generation of computers, there were several programming languages used to communicate with the computer. Low level languages are the machine codes in which the instructions are given in machine language in the form of 0 and 1 to a computer system. 0 means off and 1 means on for computer. It is mainly designed to operate and handle all the hardware and instruction set architecture of a computer. The main function of the low level language is to operate, manage and manipulate the hardware and system components. Then now machine language. It is one of the low level programming language, which is the first generation language developed for communicating with a computer. It is written in machine code, which represents binary number, that is 0 and 1. The main advantage of using machine language is that there is no need of a translator or interpreter to translate the code, as the computer directly can understand. For example, if we are going in other states, that is, we can say Nepal. There, they know the Nepali language. So we don't know about that language. So when we want to communicate with them, we need a translator or interpreter. That translator interpreter knows both the languages, that is our language and their language. So that translator or interpreter translate our language in Nepalese to them and their Nepalese language to us. Second is assembly language. It is also a low level language. It is a second generation programming language. As we know that first generation computer uses only machine language and second generation computer using assembly language that has almost similar structure and set of commands as machine language. It is also like a machine language. Instead of using numbers like in machine language, we are using two numbers 0 and 1, but here we use words or names in English forms and also symbols. We can use English form, English words and symbols. In machine language, we are using only two binary digits, but in assembly language, we are using English words and symbols also. The programs that have been written using words, names and symbols in assembly language are converted to machine language using an assembler. The main disadvantage of this language is that it is written only for a single type of CPU and does not run on any other CPU. Means, if I am writing this language on my computer system, on my CPU, it cannot be understood by the other CPU or other computer. This is the main disadvantage. So this language is not useful as other language. Now after that, low level language, high level languages will come. The high level languages are the most used and also more considered programming language that helps a programmer. Programmer means which are making that program, that is known as the programmer. Programmer to read, write and maintain. It is also the third generation language that is used and also running till now by many programmers. Nowadays we are using high level language. We are not using low level language. They are less independent to a particular type of computer because it can be understood by other CPU also. It is not dependent on one CPU. So we can say this is a independent language and also require a translator that can convert the high level language to machine level language. The translator may be an interpreter and compiler that helps to convert into binary code for a computer to understand. There is various high level programming languages like C, C++, Fortran, Pascal, Java, many other languages are there that are less independent and also enables the programmer to write a programs. Now, three characteristics of fourth generation languages. Fourth generation languages means high level language which we are using nowadays. It is highly user-friendly. User-friendly means who is using this language. This language give him the instruction which he can understand easily and independent of any operating system. It has no need to others operating system. Very high speed of execution. The speed of this language is very high. Designed to reduce level of programming efforts. Minimum efforts from the user to obtain any information. Means the user cannot devote so much time to get the information about this language making program. The features of high level languages. First, uses English word and mathematical operators. Machine independent. It is not dependent on machines. Has to be converted into machine language by translator program that translator known as interpreter and compilers. First I am explaining interpreter and compilers. Interpreter can change complete program in once, but compiler can change the programs line by line. The features of assembly level language: mnemonic codes or symbols instead of binary numbers. In high level languages, English words we are using, but assembly level languages we are using mnemonic codes or symbols. This is machine dependent language and this is machine independent language. Has to convert it into machine level language by translator programs assemblers needed. Here we need interpreter and compilers, but in assembly level language we need assemblers only. Now we discuss about the computer generation in my next video. You will complete your work which I will give and devote your so much time to your study, because nowadays only online study is going on, so that you will also be also serious about your study. Thank you.